Imagine we are in the year 2050 and all of us in this room will be hitting our sweet 60s, 70s or perhaps 80s. The reality is more frightening when I tell you that 20 to 40% of us here are estimated to develop forward hunching of our upper backs. This can be very painful, can lead to difficulty in breathing, other spinal deformities, and can severely affect our quality of life. So you go see a doctor, and your diagnosis is typically based on CT or MRI scans. Have you ever realized that all of these imaging techniques will have you lying down flat on your back, while in reality, problems of the spine are more painful and worse when we are in an upright and weight-bearing posture? Not only that, recent studies have also shown that spinal muscles, not the bone, play an important role in the onset and progression of adult spinal deformities. So, it is crucial to look at the spinal muscles, especially in the upper back and in postures other than lying down. In my study, I have developed a protocol to obtain magnetic resonance images of different people and different muscles in different postures like standing, forward flexion, sitting, and of course lying down. And all thanks to the open and upright MR scanner facility that we have at the Vancouver General Hospital, as you can see on the top right figure over there. From this data, I then calculate how big the muscles are and how far they are from the bone and what angles do they make with the spinal geometry. Interestingly enough, I have found that certain muscles increase in size and change positions by up to 25% when we are upright as compared to supine. I would now use this data to develop computer spine models to see what loads come onto the spine when we are upright and the threshold size of the muscles that can bear these loads before slowly starting to hunch forward. Both my protocol and my model can help surgeons develop patient-specific treatment strategies based on some quantitative evidence rather than going ahead with generic and experience-based approaches, which is actually the case today. Also, understanding muscle geometry in an upright posture can help us better assess the outcome and risks associated with spine surgeries while saying if your muscle structure can handle a particular type of surgery, and if yes, how well? So, ladies and gentlemen, looking ahead again at the year 2050, I reckon that my muscle research will have your back so that all of us here have the spine to age gracefully. Thank you.